RTC TV4 would like to thank all of our sponsors for our 2023 Fulton County 4-H Fair coverage. It's businesses like you that help us continue to provide this great service to our community and to document these events for future generations to enjoy. To see what's coming up in our broadcasts, visit us online at www.rtc4.com.
Central Tech Web Designs, Marty Finke. Overall, Our main exhibitors today are Beacon 50, McLean Grandstaff, Brantley Health, Bailey Jones,
Thank you. It's always good for me when we get here. We get to start off where I know I get the first box right. We got a nice single entry here. The young lady throws doors and you lamb out. She's good on her feet and legs. She gets out and moves around the ring pretty well. Then you get your hands on her. She's got more than adequate muscle for a female. She's got some rib shape, some depth of body, got that maternal look about her. Just a nice female to come out and represent the Dorsets.
Thank you.
step like you should. One of the things that hold down is fine. She's opened up. She has some rib capacity. She's moving around plenty of chin and her chest floor. Just a nice sheet for the young man sheep here in second. When he gets it stuck on the side profile like this, you like that added length of body. You like that extension about 15 now. She's got the added bone work that we really like about her. One that I would like to change as far as her depth of her rear flank in relation to her chest floor, maybe soften her up there. And then my biggest issue with this sheep that's kind of holding her in second today is when we set her into motion, I want to change how she strides out and moves on those rear two. I think the young lady sheep here in third is probably the power sheep in five. She's big and bold in her rack shape. You like that about her? She's squared out of the hip. She has an adequate amount of leg muscle to her. What I'd like to change in her shoulder design, she gets a little bit opened up in the top side of her shoulder there. If we can make that leg in a little neater, I think she can get out and stride a little better off of the front two. Put a nice individual call in three. Now get a better length here in four and five. They're similar in their design and their makeup. I think two individuals at probably a daily age, they're not as mature as a few ahead of them out here, but they're also ones that are a little bit shorter bodies as far as the body from flank to flank. And when you get your hands on from that 13th rib back, they just don't percentage out quite as well as the three above. The two nice individuals for these exhibitors. Congratulations. sheep up here in front. The young man has one that's really straight and true down that top. Has enough maternal characteristics about her as a lamb at this age. I really like the base width of this sheep and how it gets out and moves free and easy. It's really good on those feet and legs when we set her into motion. Young lady sheep here in the second one we talked about, as well as being robust in her rib cage here. A yearly ewe, like we talked about in 5-1, that's really big and bold in her rib design. I like that about her. One that's really good in her rack shape and her top shape when we get our hands on her. One I'd maybe like to soften up in her bone work a little bit, put a little bit more of that Hampshire wool on that head and legs, a little more showing high appeal. I think it's pretty close placing in my mind, but today we're going to make the young man Lamb. Another one that's really good about our Hampshire breed character. You love the stoutness of her foot size, that bone work that she possesses. And like we talked about in class, that's one I'd like to change when we set her into motion and maybe drop her in that rear flank a little bit. I think for me today, you know, when I look at sheep that we're going to take home and put into production, they got to be pretty bolt free and easy movement. And that's when you make your decisions, I think, is when we set these sheep into motion, how well they track and move around the ring. And that's going to be our separation today. The yearling will be a reserve. Congratulations. I think we got a really nice individual entry here. One that can definitely stand some more competition. She's really elevated and clean about that front one third. I love that about that sheep. She ties that neck shoulder in really well. She's straight and true down that top. She has some body, has some capacity. She's standing on a good set of feet legs. Just a nice individual. We'll analyze later when we get out here for champion natural colors.
First place. In the natural color feline class, it's Ryan Strasser. We now have two entries in the Euro natural color class.
more opened up in that four rib, especially when we compare to the one in second. She's got a big top, but a nice square hip. She's wider in her pin set than the sheep in second here, and that's why she's going to go ahead and win the class. Young lady sheep here in second, the darker blue one, one that's really upended. I really love the front one-third of that sheep and how she's designed there. She's really straight and true on that top. She gets out and moves free and easy. One I just need to open up in her rib cage and her design and give her some more overall mass and dimension to compete with the sheep ahead of her. But a nice individual. Congratulations.
Thank you.
representatives out here for the polyphase. I think there's a little bit of give and take between them, even though they're very similar in their body type and their design. We're going to start with the young man up front here. I think what separates it for me is she's just a little bit wider face, and when you turn and hit her out and watch her go away from you, she keeps that face with. She tracks wide, she tracks true. I think that's what's going to excel and put her up here in front for me today. Take nothing away from the young man. She here in second one, and maybe is slightly a little bolder in her rib design. I really like that about that individual. But when we set her in the motion, she kind of wants to throw that right rear just a little bit. And I think if we could change how she handles that right rear hot, we'd put her up in the top of the class. Congratulations. Just a little bit coarser about her makeup. Her neck wants to kind of come out of the front. front side of her shoulder a little bit. If we can get her to relax and set that back up on top of her shoulder, and maybe relax that spine right there in the center of her back. As she gets that loose, put a nice individual to come out here and represent the Proctors. Congratulations. As we just talked about them individually, I think you bring them out here and pair them up, they complement each other fairly well. They're similar in their bone work and their design as far as that goes. I think where maybe one's lacking a little bit in her rib design, the other makes up for it. A nice pair of ewes to go back and put into the flock and put into the breeding program to go ahead and advance these young people forward. Congratulations.
Thank you.
going to go ahead and start with the young lady up front here. Just a nice sheep. I think she's not really wanting to get out here and present herself to everybody today. She's a little gun shy, but I think when we sit here and we analyze the pieces and parts that are there, she's a little bit stouter in her foot size and her bone work. I really like that about her. She's really maternal and she has that massive volume that I like to see. When the young lady gets her propped up here, I think she gives us a pretty good sight profile look that we can appreciate. Young man sheep here in second one that's really up-headed, like that front one third about that sheep. One that shortens up from flank to flank for me. And like I said, compared to our class winner, just a little lighter in her bone work. I think just a nice individual that when you set her into motion, she gets out and moves pretty free and easy. She stays pretty straight and true in her top line. I appreciate that about her. Just a nice individual to come out here and fall into second today. Congratulations.
Well, first and second place are submitted by Carter Hott and now be exhibited as a pair of yearling ewes.
Kind of similar to our pair of ewe lambs we had previously. This pair, they kind of complement each other pretty well. They're both good about their Shropshire breed character. One's a little bit stouter bone than the other one. Has a little bit more mass and dimension. I think when you go back and you put them in a breeding program and you add them to the bucks in your buck battery lineup back at the barn, I think two nice individuals that can go out and propel this program forward. Congratulations.
Thank you.
She's straight and true down that top. She has more than enough body and capacity to her. She's adequate in motion too. You set her in motion, she keeps that chest core open. She drags out free and easy, just gets out and moves around the ring really well. Young lady, she appeared in second. That's a big power. She's in the class. If you're in the top down weather game and you're wanting to make Marcus Lambs, that's the sheep you want out here. I think for me today, she's a little deeper in her chest floor than I would like to see at this age. And then when you set her into motion, she drops that chest floor. She wants to get her head out in front of her. And I think that's kind of what separates it for me today from the one up front. Young man, sheep here in third is more similar to the style and kind that we see in our platforms. One that's really up-headed and really feminine and stylish from the side profile. But one that you get behind her simply just not enough sheep there. We need to open her up in her ribcage and her spine to give her some more overall muscle and power to compete with those sheep ahead of her. Congratulations.
Placing to the Southbound Greyhound class, first to Olivia Jones, second to Emily Viger, third to Olivia Jones. Now ready for Southbound Yearly Use, two entries. Oh, we should have a pair of Southbound Greyhounds that come back in.
2018, I think we got a little difference in type and kind here. Young lady, we're going to start off with this, the power sheep in this class. If you're looking at the Southdown game and make weather, she kind of fits that mold. But I think this one here with all that top shape and that hip shape and that power, she also ties it together with a pretty elegant and feminine front end. Her neck sits right up on the top side of her shoulder, and the young lady gets her propped up right there like that. Pretty as a picture and nice to look at. Just an easy individual to come out here and use in this class. Young lady, she's in second to none. It's really feminine and elegant about that front one third. You like that about her. You like the little swoop to her belly line, that maximum dimension that she has. I think for me, I've changed her in her hip structure and her design, widen her out, her fin set, to give her a little more overall muscle mass to compete with this sheep ahead of her. But a nice individual. Congratulations. think we got a really powerful female to lead off the class here. One that's really broad about her skull structure. I really like that breed character about her. One that's pretty straight and true. When you sit back and analyze this breed, I think this is one that's really, really bold and has a really good sign. She's really maternal looking. She's pretty smooth down that top. I know within this breed, that's not the biggest thing as far as being the straight top, but I think this one ties everything together pretty well. When you set her into motion, she keeps everything together really well as she gets out and moves. I think the sheep that most closely follows her in Tiger County is the one in the second. I think that sheep just simply gives up a little bit of that overall mass and dimension she has in the ones leading off the class. And then we get to the young man sheep here in the third, another nice individual that's really good about that breed character, that sculpture structure and that design. The one that just gets a little bit higher in that overall muscle mass and development compared to the two ewes ahead of them. Congratulations.
Placing in the Texas UAM class, first is Ava Held, second, Lane Held, and third, Jonathan Held. Those lands are all county born, so Ava's will be the champion county born Texel, and Lane's a reserve champion. Now we're for the Black Face Crossbreds, four entries.
Thank you.
think we got a class runner comes out here and does so quite handily. One is pretty to the ground. He's bold about that foam work and that structure. He's elegant and feminine about that front end. He's really long when you get your hands on it and handle it from that 13th rib back. That's more than enough as far as muscle shape and power to her to be out here in the female division. It's a nice individual to not win the class. Young lady sheep in here in a second. I really like the mass and dimension and the body that this female possesses. She's another one that's good at the ground. She's really bold about her bone work and her structure. But she's one that gets a little bit deeper in her chest floor, a little more forward out of that shoulder, her neck coming out of her shoulder. And you can see that especially when we set her in a motion and watch her get out and go out of her even so long, drop that chest floor and then take off straight.
Yeah.
type of period sheet, one that's really elegant, feminine about that front one third. Probably has the added advantage in length of body and your antlers from that 13th rib back. The one that's just giving up a little bit of that overall max and dimension and power that you see in that one ahead of her. I think if we can get that one to be a little fresher and tie together better, and a good construction, maybe pushes that sheep up in front just a little bit harder. I think we get to a pair of U-legs here in 3 and 4 that are similar in their type and their kind and their makeup. They're carrying just a little more condition than the two U's ahead of them, so they're a little softer to the touch when you handle them. They're not as true in that muscle shape and mass of muscle as we see as the two sheep ahead of them. The two nice females that have some rib shape, have some body, staying on a good set of these legs. It's nice individuals. Congratulations. stands there just like that. I think she's pretty as a picture. She's really elegant about that front one third. She has the overall mass and dimension and power we're looking for in these kind of females. I think young man sheep here in a second, take nothing away from that. She's a really nice functional sheep. It's good on his feet and legs. Really extended about that front one third, straight and true down that top. I'd just like to open that sheep up, give it a little more rib capacity, more body capacity there, and open it up as far as its pit lid, give it some more overall mass and dimension to compete with her, whatever. But a nice individual around her. Congratulations.
Blessings in our black face. Rolling shoes. First, the Henry Biker. Second, the Colin Grisma. That concludes our briefs that we're going to do in these classes. We'll now select our grand champions here, so we'll get the champions from each of the briefs.
That you land out of your own place and you've had from day one, and
after selection of the Grand Canyon View and Grand Canyon County Board View, we'll be taking a 15-minute break while we take pictures of those canyons, and then we'll start the markup land show. So a 15-minute break after showing the
Thank you.
another class, or increase.
Thank you.
make improvements on, you know, a piece at a time. There's never a perfect one out there. If somebody tells you there is, they're full of it. It's never going to happen. There's not a perfect sheep out there. There's not a perfect calf out there. There's not a perfect dog. But we try to make improvements and make them better and make them more eye-appealing out here in the show ring. I'll go out here and select the one that I feel like makes your champion name and daughter today. Congratulations, young people.
Down heavily in that journey.
kind of a little bit of a challenging class here. There's definitely some give and take. I'm going to start with the young lady up front here. One that's, he's a little growthy at this point. He's really tall at the point of his shoulder. He's a big outline kind of a sheep. One that when you get your hands on him, he's good in his rack shape. I'd probably like to change him and widen him out in his loin, thicken him up there just a little bit. But he's one that probably handles a little fresher than the other two within this class. Just a nice individual to kind of come out here and win the class. Young lady sheep here in second. One that bounces up pretty well from the side. One that's decent from the touch. He's carrying just a little bit more condition than I would prefer to see at this stage of the game. The one that has some muscle shape and some mass and dimension to him. And you got to appreciate that about it. Young lady sheep here in third. One that's similar as far as its muscle mass and development that we see in the one just ahead of it. I think that's one that structurally I'd like to change a little bit. His hip design, he shortens up a little bit. I think if we lengthen that hip out, we set him into motion, he'll move a little freer and easier. But a nice individual to round out the class. Congratulations.
Questions in the heavyweight class. First, to Alexa Lyle. Second, Diane Young. And third, Kaylin Olamide. We'll now select the champion Hampshire Blocker Lyle. Lightweight class was won by Kate Jones, middleweight by Max Summers, and heavyweight by Alexa Lyle. Ah. Ah. Class 2, and Kaylin Olamide from Class 3.
three individuals out for our county born and bred champion. I think for me today, we're going to go with the young man's lightweight lamb. I see more future in this sheep with the structural build and design and the amount of muscle that he possesses and the touch that he has today. Congratulations.
Thank you.
young man up front here with the weather. He's just really big and bald in his muscle shape. There's no doubt about him. He's maybe getting close to having just a tick too much condition on him, but I think he's ideal. He's acceptable today. I think one that just comes out of here with his overall mass and dimension just goes on and wins the class. Young man, you line here in second. When you look at her when she comes in, she's one that she's really popping in that track. She's really bold and expressive in that shape. She's just coming in a smaller frame package when you compare her to the one ahead of her. And I think one, when we get it out, we really analyze how much total products there. I think she's going to come in second in that category, and that's why she's going to fall in second today. I think we get to a pair of lamps here in three and four that are similar in their design and their makeup. I think she can just give it up some of that overall mass and dimension that we see ahead of them. But really nice commercial functional sheep that'll go out and hang a nice carcass on a rail and do a nice job for these young ladies. Congratulations.
This is in the Shropshire Markland class. First to Anna Rolmeyer. Second to Max Summer. Third and fourth, Colin High. Now a pair of Shropshire Markland lambs.
but that's getting pretty critical. That's a pretty nice individual to come out here and win the class. Young lady, she's been second. I think that's that advantage in freshness and trimness and touch when you get your hands on him. I love the way that she handles in his rack shape. I just need more of it. I need more rack shape. I'd like to work him up out of his pin set and give him a little more of that lower leg shape that we see in the sheep ahead of him. The young lady sheep here in third is one that's more similar in body type and kind to our class winner, but one that just gets a little bit more wasty as far as his condition goes. He gets a little looser structured, a little bit deeper in his chest board, but one that's similar in that body type and design that we have in our class winner. Just a nice individual that falls in the third. When we get here to 4 and 5 with 2 sheep that are pretty similar, I think you got both sheep that are really upheaded. I like that about them. They're really straight and smooth in their lines. I think sheep that just need to have more mass and dimension to compete with the sheep ahead of them. Congratulations.
Placing in the South Zone Mother class. First, Bailey Lutzer. Second, and champion County Warren is Olivia Jones. Third, Caleb Holmeyer. Fourth, Caleb Liam McCarthy. And fifth, Jake Geller.
Nice individual here representing the Texas. I think this is a breed that when you talk about the amount of product and muscle and meat that's in this sheep, when you put it on the, as far as what's on that framework and that skeleton that sheep has, I think he's a very well representative of the Texas breed and looks really good out here in the show ring. Congratulations.
Champion Texel Lamb and County Board Champion exhibited by Ava Helms. Now we're here with class 34, Whiteface Clark at Lamb. 3 entries.
Thank you.
market lamb with the amount of muscle he has. He walks away with the class quite easily, I think. One that's really good on his feet and legs, gets out and moves pretty easy. Just a nice individual to win the class. Young lady sheep here in second gives you a really nice side profile. You like that about that sheep? He's really up-headed. He's straight and true down that top. He's probably the one carrying the most condition in the class as well. I think we clean him up in that condition, trim him up, get a little pressure to the touch. I don't think there's as much overall muscle and product in that sheep as our class winner, but a nice individual to fall in second. Young lady sheep here in third. He's probably the greenest one in the class. He handles really firm and crisp. I like that about him. Just structurally, I'd like to change him a couple of places to make him get out and move a little freer and easier. But a nice individual to come out and be in the market line division. Congratulations.
Now we look at class 36, heavyweight, black 35 on the
I think we have a really tough class here as far as quality within the class. This is probably the deepest we've had in the market time show. I think the two individuals up here at top are very similar in their design and their makeup, the amount of muscle that each of these sheep possess. Both these exhibitors have these sheep dialed in for today. They handle fresh and crisp and clean. I think when it comes down to it, it's a finer point when you separate between the two. We set them into motion. Again, I think this sheep up front, the young man has, holds himself together just a nickel better. He keeps that chest forward up hitting just a little bit. He's a little bit shorter about that shoulder blade as far as that height there. He's a sheep that runs uphill. He's big and bold and expressive and his muscle shape. Just a nice individual to come out here and win the class. Like I said, it's a close placing in my mind. It's those minor details that we're going to pick apart today on the second sheep. Maybe if he keeps that chest score up in just a little bit better, and it's even within that under hock when we set him into motion, if we can change that hock, how it moves and flexes, I think that sheep becomes more competitive with the one ahead of it, but a very nice individual in his own right. Young lady sheep here in third, a really nice sheep to bring out here. I think one that possesses a lot of muscle shape and a lot of power, and he's really smooth and he balances really well. He's the heaviest condition in this class, and I think he just kind of ran into a buzzsaw of a class here that gets really, really competitive in really deep waters, and she finds herself in third today, but a nice slam to come out here and analyze. Congratulations.
Placing in class 36, first, Connor Summers, second, Gavin Lightyear, and third, Lanny Allen. And I select the champion, Blackface Cross, Mark Ryan.
I think we've had a really nice black-based cross division out here. I think we got four individuals that have come out here and represent the Market Land Division really well. They're really big and bold in their muscle shape. They handle fresh and crisp. I think there's some minor differences in my mind, what I see out here and what I'm looking for. I think I still need one to be structurally correct, get up, move free and easy. I think when we go in and we're breeding for market lambs, not all of them are male sheep. We're going to have females as well. With that being said, you know, we still need to place some emphasis on structural integrity and design and foot size and bone work and then how much muscle and shape can we put on there and keep it in a fresh touch. And I think we've got some really nice representatives of that out here. I'll go out and show you the two that I prefer, but congratulations to all four of you. Champion County born and bred market lamb. I think we get out here, we've got a lightweight lamb that's really green and fresh and has some future to him. Then we got the young lady's lamb here. He's at that market weight. He's ready. He's a big, bold, powerful sheep, but he's got plenty of condition on him today. But two nice individuals to represent your county born and bred. Today, your champion will be the lightweight. Congratulations.
Michael Langer, exhibit the County Board Champion Blackface Marco Lamb.
Got a nice single entry here in the pair division. I think, you know, both these lambs were out here in your champion blackface drive, both very deserving. You pair them up, they're similar in their muscle shape and design. I think just two nice individuals to win the class. Congratulations.
Michael Now ready to respect our grand champion, Mark Owen.
Ah!
have a lot of classes with more than like 3 or 4 in them, but I think we get them out here in our grand drive, and there's quite a bit of quality to sit back and analyze. I think there's similars, characteristics within each one of the breed divisions we have out here. I think, there's 5 or 6 I've kind of looked at, plus there's some back here that are second place we'll bring out as we start selecting our top 5. But like I said earlier, we get to a market lane show. It's not purely on muscle and power. I think that's the biggest percentage of it. But these sheep still need to be functional. They still need to look stylish. They need to look cool. They need to have a showing presence to them. They start to look around. They've got to build from there up. They've got to be good on their feet and legs. They got to get out and move free and easy. They got to be attractive. And then how much muscle and mass can we build on that framework and make those sheep look really cool out here in the meet? I'll go out and select the top 5 for you. Let's congratulate these exhibitors one more time.
Yeah.
players here that's in the county and being able to bring them to the fair and get them presented and get them looking right. I think there's one out here in my mind who's never really given us a great look today, but I think if you can read into that sheep a little bit, predict the future. I'm pretty comfortable liking that one, the champion. Young man here in second, being a champion, county born and bred.
Congratulations.
together for our beginner showman out here today. All these individuals have done a real nice job all day. I kind of like showmanship being at the end of the day, just a personal preference, I guess, because I get to watch these kids show all day, and that's one of my things is when you come out for showmanship, you better not show different than when you show it in class. I think whenever you hit that entrance gate, it's game on. That's what we teach our son. When you're in the waiting room, you got to get focused. So when you hit that gate, you hit the shavings or the bars, whatever it is, it's game time. It's just like playing basketball or soccer or whatever sport you want. This is your sport today, and it's time to play when you hit the game. I think there's one young man out here that's done a really nice job all day. He does a good job of working with his lamb. He's got that sheep set up on all four corners most of the time. I think when you hear me, Judge, and you talk about showmanship, I always talk about all four corners and getting those sheep placed. And I think getting that head placement right is a key. I think when we're in a beginner age, I like to see head placement and how you work with the head of that sheep is the most important thing. If you get that sheep trained and you are able to get that head and neck set where it needs to be, everything else will pretty well fall into place. I think there's one young man out here that's done that exemplarily today. Young man in the back will be your champion. Congratulations.
Grades 5 through 8.
to this age division, I get a little bit more critical on feet placement. You know, we talk about the beginners, I like how you hold that head. You got to hold the head properly. If you hold the head properly, everything else kind of falls into place. It won't be perfect at every time, but this is the stage now. You guys are old enough, you're big enough. You should be able to reach back and set those hind legs. If that's how you have your sheep trained, if you have it trained when you push into it to drive and it places itself, I'm okay with that as well. But you got to be able to do that with your sheep. And when we talk about setting them on all four quarters, this is the age group where I get really more critical on that and the process of how you get there. You know, I want it to look fluid. I want it to look neat. You need to have a little bit of intensity and fire, I guess, to get to that point quickly so that I always have a good look at that lamb. I think we have a couple individuals out here that stood out in my mind. Today, your champion is going to be the young lady in the back right here, the Dorsey Advantage. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let's put our hands together for our senior today. I think he's been a really fun group of kids to work with. I think it's challenging. I think they push each other out here. I think there's a number of different ways the guy can go when he's making his selection as well. I think for me today, there's one out here that stands out. In my mind, a person that has that sheep in line where it should be at all times, it's in the right place. They're one of the quickest about getting that sheep set up on all four corners. You can tell that person and that sheep have worked together quite a bit. They know the role that each one of them plays, and then they have that sheep set up so that we get a good look at it no matter what angle we're at. They're in the right position in the ring. They have that presence about them to know what's around them. Young lady in your red shirt will be your champion. Congratulations.
Spent a week in Mexico working with the producers and the
down there in San Miguel, and we did a training course, and we worked with individuals there that paid to come and take this course, and it was some guys that were from Mexico that are veterinarians that were putting on the course, and then us two guys here from the United States, and we went down there, and we helped them teach an instructional course on how we evaluate and the process of how we do things in the show ring, and work with them down there. And that was a really cool experience for us to go down and do that and just see a different part of Mexico that was not the tourist part where it's all ocean and beach. You know, we were central Mexico, and then you talk about a beautiful countryside and the chapels there, the scenery to go look at, the people to meet, and the connection we've made there. That was a pretty cool experience for me. So those are some of the highlights and background that we have about me and my past judging experience. So thank you guys for having me to Fulton County. I've appreciated the opportunity. I think once everybody's feeling good here in our senior division here, we'll go ahead and get started and roll on with that. We'll pick your master showman. Congratulations.
Wrestling around with their trainer.
Let's put our hands together and congratulate all three of these exhibitors. I think all three of these have done an excellent job all afternoon. We've been out here, they've been fun to work with. I don't want to work them too hard here in the championship. I mean, we watched them show all day. We know what they're capable of. I think as the younger kids sitting around the ring, I think you've got some good leaders and mentors in the three individuals out here that you guys can gain a lot of knowledge from and a lot of skill set from. I think they're good individuals to look up to as far as their personalities, that I've gotten to know them here just a little bit in the ring. But as far as their showmanship skills and how they present these sheep, they do an excellent job. I think you get down to it, I think I'm on one that's set on all four corners all the time, like I talk about. No matter what angle you get, you're going to get a good look at that sheep. I think for me today, the person that's done that throughout the entire day is the young lady in the red shirt. She's going to be your champion.
Congratulations. And over 5 years, the master
RTC-TV4 would like to thank all of our sponsors for our 2023 Fulton County 4-H Fair coverage. It's businesses like you that help us continue to provide this great service to our community and to document these events for future generations to enjoy. To see what's coming up in our broadcasts, visit us online at www.rtc4.com.